With the latest Home Assistant release, you can now have an entirely local AI that can help you control your smart home. All of that can happen thanks to Home Assistant Assist and Ollama. And let's see how it is working. Is it good or bad? Is it hallucinating a lot? And at the end of the day, is it usable at this stage? I'll also show you what I did to have this setup up and running so you can test it by yourself if you wish. And without further ado, let's start. This is my test Home Assistant environment. Everything is set up and ready to be used. I'll just click on this assist button and I'll start typing. For example, my eyes hurt. Can you stop the show? Took care of the living room lights. If you meant all other devices, I need to know which area you want me to turn off. And actually, this local AI, Ollama Home Assistant integration, turn off everything inside my living room. Kind of okay, because I honestly wanted only TV to be turned off, but nevertheless, the lights can also hurt my eyes, in theory, so this thing turned off everything in my living room. How did it know that I'm in the living room? I don't know, it just decided that I'm there. It is not true, by the way. Let's try something else. I'm bored. Can you entertain me in the living room? Now I'm expecting the TV to be turned on. And no, everything is turned on. Also the lights. It answers about the lights. Turning on the lights in the living room. Now it's a bit brighter in there. Okay, that means for the local AI that if there is a light, I should be entertained. Maybe that's true, maybe that's not. Maybe that's part of the AI hallucinating. I don't know. Let's try something else. Just have in mind that these answers that you see right here are not consistent. Sometimes they're correct, most of the times they are not. Some of the times the local AI is saying something like I cannot help you and stuff like that. Other times it turns on or off everything in a specific room like you just saw. And very, very rarely it turns on or off a specific device that I wanted. If you name it exactly, it will help, but that's not the point of AI. Because without AI, the Home Assistant, the native Home Assistant Assist will do the same. So it doesn't help a lot. Nevertheless, let's try something else. I'm a bit sleepy and I need a coffee. Let's see, the coffee machine is turned off at the moment. Yes, it is turned on now. Maybe it will perk you up. Good. I set this environment to answer with sassy and passive-aggressive style. Let me quickly show you that. Manage Assistant. Download my updated and enhanced smart home glossary that is full of smart home wisdom. You can find the link on your screen and in the video description. This is my pipeline and this is the conversation agent, but more on that later. I just want to show you this config file. You're a voice assistant for Home Assistant. Answer questions for the world truthfully. Answer in plain text and be very sassy and passive aggressive. This is what I'm expecting. This is just for fun. But it answers that way very rarely, unfortunately. But from time to time it answers, so it's fine. Let's try one more thing or few more things. I want to have a bath, but it is too bright in the bedroom. The neighbors will see me. This is one long and not very clever sentence, but let's see what will happen. It's thinking. Have in mind that I'm using MacBook M1 with Apple Silicon. I'm not sure what you mean by neighbors will see me. Are you trying to be modest? Anyway, I've turned off the bedroom lights. You should be able to have your bath now. And the bedroom lights are not turned off. And this definitely is the AI hallucination. It says something that it thinks it's true, but it is not. The bedroom lights are not turned off. Also, I have a lot of other text, which is useless. I want to sleep, but it is too bright in the bedroom. Let's try that way. I want to sleep, but it is too bright in the bedroom. Let's try that way. I wanted to say that I'm using Ollama running on my MacBook with Apple Silicon M1 processor. It is not the latest and the greatest one, but it is fast enough, and the answers are not lightning fast. Sometimes it took probably 30 seconds to answer, but most of the times are below 10, so it's kind of usable. I already turned off the bedroom lights. It is still thinking that the bedroom lights are turned off, but they are not. And that is a good time to say that I'm not recommending AI in your home assistant at this stage, apart from playing and testing. Don't use it in your production home assistant environment, as it is very, very inconsistent and strange. Nevertheless, it is fun playing with it. I also want to show you something important. If you click on an entity like this one, then on this settings wheel button, and then on voice assistant, you can define aliases here, and these aliases help Home Assistant Assist to identify better your devices, and you can type whatever you wish here, and you can add a lot of aliases if you wish for one device. Also, this assist switch here is very important. If this is turned off, this device will not be exposed to Home Assistant Assist, and you will not be able to control it with the assist. But if this is turned on, you'll be able to control it with the Home Assistant Assist. So have in mind these things when you configure your Home Assistant setup. Let's try something with the reading lights. For example, I'll not read anymore in the bedroom. Save me some money. Let's see if it is going to turn off the reading lights. I'm expecting that, but let's see what will happen. It is thinking, I don't have the ability to make changes or purchases. I can only provide information and assist with simple tasks. Sorry, but I think this local AI thing at the moment is not very useful. But this is a big progress because until very recently, you didn't have the chance to allow the local AI to control your home assistant. This is a new stuff. I have an older video about Home Assistant Ollama integration that I'll link right here. You can check all the details, how I set up the things there. And this time I'm using the same steps apart from different LLM model. But let me quickly show you what I did. First, I downloaded this Ollama client from here, from the ollama.com website. It is available for Windows, Linux, and macOS. I'm using macOS. Then I started this Ollama project, and I have this cute Ollama icon right here. After that, I exposed my Ollama setup to my local network so Home Assistant can connect to it remotely. And I did that by using this export Ollama host and the IP of my laptop where Ollama is running. After that, I restarted my Ollama. If you are using Linux or Windows, you have to follow the steps shared in the Ollama integration web page here, accessible over internet. I'll share this in the video description, so don't bother to remember where it is. Here, these are the steps for Linux. Where are they? These are the Linux steps, and below and above somewhere here, and also the Windows here. And after you expose your local Ollama installation over your local network, you can add the Ollama integration. As usual, add integration, you have to search for Ollama, and here you have to type HTTP, your IP of the device where Ollama is running, and port. For example, this is my IP, and port, the default port is 11434. Like that. And now I have another dialog where I can download an LLM model. The best one for now is this one, LLama or Llama 3.1 latest. You just have to select that and you can use it. I also tried with the other models, Llama 3 and Llama 2, but they're not working well. I received some errors about missing tools and stuff like that. This LLM is the most powerful one at the moment. It is coming from Meta, the company behind Facebook and Instagram. In my previous Home Assistant Ollama video, I received several comments that I'll never get something from Meta inside my house ever and stuff like that. I know I don't like them either, but they did a great job here. I have to admit that. This local LLM model is costing millions of dollars and they share it for free. And if you're using it, nothing is leaving your home network. Everything stays local. And that is a good thing. Nothing is shared with Mark Zuckerberg and his team, and that should be fine. Also, on top of that, you can treat this local AI, local LLM as a virus. You can run this in a virtual machine and then you can destroy it. You can have this virtual machine running without any internet connection. So it is good for playing and for fun, but not for production environment. Nevertheless, the next step is to choose your model. This is the latest and greatest, and you just have to submit. And now I have these added in my Home Assistant as conversation agent. To use this conversation agent, I have to edit my pipeline. Register for my upcoming Home Assistant webinar, where we will talk about different Home Assistant installation types. It is all free and you can find the link on your screen and in the video description. From here, manage assistants. This is my default and only pipeline that I have. And here I can select my conversation agent. These are the older models and these are the latest. This is the duplicate one that I just added. If I select this, I can change the instructions here. Like I showed you, I can add here be sassy and passive aggressive. These control Home Assistant options are important here. If you leave it on no control, this conversation agent will not have the rights to control your devices. But if you leave it on assist, Ollama and Home Assistant Assist will be able to control your entities and devices. And this is the new option that is added in the latest Home Assistant version. And before that, only the no control or read-only mode was possible with the local AI like Ollama. Now you can use Ollama and Home Assistant Assist to actually control your smart home, as you saw in the beginning of the video. And basically that's it. You have to select conversation agent. This is a good setup if you want to type your comments. If you want to use voice, you have to change these things a bit. But for more detailed explanation of these options right here and how to enable voice control, you can check some of my other AI videos where I'm playing with ChatGPT and Google Generative AI called Gemini and Home Assistant, and there I'm using my voice and text commands to demonstrate how AI is working. The voice configuration can be reused without any modifications. If you have a Home Assistant Cloud subscription, or also known as Nabucasa subscription, you can use Cloud Speech to Text and Text to Speech Processing, which are very fast. Otherwise, you can use your local machine to do the same. And if your local machine is fast, this processing of the voice will be fast as well. And I want to say it again, don't use AI in your Home Assistant apart from playing and experimenting in a safe sandbox. We're not there just yet, but it is a step forward and I like all of that. Thank you for AI hallucinating with me. I'm Kiryu and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!